Hey, how are you doing? This is Greg Van Kirk, and I'd just like to take a few minutes here to walk you through this journey map, collaborative conversation tool. This is for the how might we figure out what's getting in the way of someone achieving a goal. So, as always, on the top left here, we've got about this journey map. I'm gonna read through that. Below that is how this journey map works in the header below that. Which is guidance for the tool that you see here on the right, the actual journey map built in Google Sheets. So, as always, you can, what you see on the top here, you can click here or on the tool to access the Google Sheet, make an editable copy, right? So, go into there, you'll be able to view it and then go and make an editable copy for you and your team or your community or folks that you're working with. In the PDF that you download here in this tools letter, these are separate sheets. They're not side by side, but they're side by side here because it's a lot easier for me to walk you through it in that way, and you can and easier for you to understand how this works. And then after walking you through this, I'm just going to go through a few examples of what hats do you wear, 12 application ideas, right? As always, guidance on how you might put this into action, how you might put this to use to help you if you're wearing one of these hats. So if we go back to the top left about this journey map. What are all the steps that someone needs to take to achieve their goal? Which ones are easy? Which ones are difficult? Which ones might be so difficult that they're getting in the way of success? This journey map tool should help you and your team figure all of this out. Inspired by the commonly used customer journey map, there are two different ways that you can use this tool. With both approaches, start with the goal. For the first approach, work backward from the last activity required to achieve the goal. For example, if the goal is to arrive at work safely and on time, the last activity might be get off the bus, right before you walk into work. Start there and then go back in time step by step. With the second approach, do the opposite. Decide a starting point and work forward to the goal. Using the same example, with this approach, you might want to start with get out of bed and then go forward in time. There's no right approach. Just use the one that's most helpful given the current context. So, as you can see here, the tool on the right, pretty straightforward. So, what we want to do is, as noted, just first, what's the goal? What's someone trying to achieve? And that's where we're trying to get to. And then we want to know what's the journey to be able to achieve that goal. So, if you look at the top left-hand column, we have journey, right? The actual journey. These are the steps in the journey. You have your step number, and then the activity description, right? As before, it put here. Might be get off the bus or get out of bed, right? You're going to do it in whatever order you want to, starting with the earliest thing or the latest thing. So note down all the steps in the journey. Really important, as I continually say here, be as specific as humanly possible, right? Be very, 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 very specific. Because so oftentimes, like you have in the Muhammad Ali quote over here on the left, is often it isn't the mountains ahead that wear you out, it's the little pebble in your shoe. Right, which means you need to be very, very specific. Sometimes it's the little things that trip you up the most and that you need to solve for. So write down the journey, steps, all the steps. You can add more steps, fewer steps, right? Work with this in Google Sheets. Then on analysis, what you want to put is the difficulty of that activity. So 0, really easy, not a problem at all. 5, really, really, really difficult, right? So it might be get the bus, might be a 5. It's really difficult because the bus never shows up on time. Right? That's a problem. Maybe then that's a problem that we can solve for, that you can solve for, you can help somebody out with. So after you put the difficulty level, you might want to talk about that as a team. Why this level of difficulty? So an explanation of why did you put a 0, a 3, or a 5, for example. And then ideas for solutions. Needless to say, you want to ideate on solutions for the most difficult things first, right? That's where you want to step in ideally. So how might you solve for those problems? But as you can see, overall, just a really simple way to walk through what's a journey of someone trying to achieve a goal, try to figure out what's easy, what's difficult, and then in your role as a change maker, as collaborative change makers, is to try to figure out how can you help something that's difficult become much easier. So solve for those pain points. As I put, if you see on the left here in the post-it note, just more emphasis where I say be as specific as possible. It's often the relatively small and overlooked steps that cause failure. If someone isn't working, if something isn't working, excuse me, use this to walk through the steps with the person who's negatively affected, right? We want to include the folks who are affected in this conversation and not make assumptions. So in terms of what hats do you wear, so 12 application ideas. If you look at businesses, create a journey map for your potential and/or existing customers to help you figure out where you can add value and/or improve. You can also use this to analyze internal processes, right? If I look at consultants down on the left, have your clients use this to better understand their team members, partners, and/or clients, right? What can they solve for? Students on the left use this for service learning, et cetera, to help better understand community members, right? What are their journeys, right? Where can we help them out? Use this when engaged in venture startup competitions to figure out the priority pain points to solve for. If I go over to nonprofits, use this to better understand how and where to serve community members you aspire to support. What are they hoping to achieve? What are their goals? What are the steps on how they're trying to get there, and how can you step in and help them out? And if I look down at individuals, right, always a great place to start. Make journey maps for yourself to help you anticipate and overcome challenges. So that is our journey map. A great tool to have in your toolbox. Hopefully, you find this helpful. As always, if you have any questions, concerns, need any support, want to collaborate, don't hesitate to reach out. It's what I'm here for. Apart from that, all the best and have a wonderful day.